welcome to BrainStuff. I'm Jonathan Strickland. Today's question is, how do polygraph machines work? Well, those are lie detector machines. We need to define some things. Poly means many. It's from the Greek word for many. And in this case, the many refers to the many sensors used by the machine. Now, these sensors detect changes in your body, things like your heart rate or your blood pressure or whether or not you're sweating or maybe if you're taking deep or shallow breaths. Now, the graph part of polygraph comes from the Greek word meaning writing. And in the case of this machine, the writing is talking about that strip of paper, you know, where you see the needle making the line, or maybe there's several needles. That would represent the actual changes being detected by the sensors that are attached to your body. So as your body reacts in different ways, it's recorded on this piece of paper. If you have a little reaction, it's a smooth line. Big reactions are big jumps. Now, more modern polygraph machines actually use digital readouts rather than that piece of paper, though some people prefer the paper because it has a sort of psychological effect. So, how does this actually work? You get an interrogator asking someone various questions. First, they ask a few baseline questions to get the normal response to being interrogated.
Is your name Jonathan Strickland?
Yes. Then the interrogator alternates between what are called target questions and other baseline questions.
Do you have facial hair?
Yes.
Have you showered today?
Yes.
Huh.
Now, after the questioning, the interrogator starts looking at those target questions, looking for big signs of activity. That indicates that the person being interviewed has had a stress response to being asked that question, which could indicate a lie. But here's a problem. This approach assumes a standard response to lying or even being interrogated, which isn't how humans work, actually. Some people may have elevated signs simply through experiencing stress while being questioned. Other people, you know, the cool customers, the sociopaths, they might be able to just spout off outrageous lies without so much as a blip on the radar. Now, ultimately, lie detector tests are a poor tool to judge if someone's lying. They really just judge if they're uncomfortable. What they're really, really good at is coaxing confessions. You see, if a person thinks that the polygraph machine is actually working, they may be worried about being caught out in a lie and be more inclined to come clean. But as for a scientifically sound way of determining whether or not someone is actually lying, it's a bust. Now, this has led some, but not all, countries to rule that polygraph evidence is inadmissible in a court of law. Ours is not necessarily one of those. So, that's how polygraphs work, or how they don't work, depending upon your point of view. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you like it and subscribe to our channel. We're going to be answering lots more questions pretty soon. That's the truth.